and then, and then. So you guys are absolutely right. Somebody told me that the histogram had numbers at the bottom where the bar graph had just some simple levels. That is because a histogram has an interval or a range, okay? So we're just gonna write something simple. Everybody grab your pencil for our vocabulary. Go to your vocab box, okay?
So TAPPLE is very important to explicit direct instruction. That first piece is me teaching whatever concept or skill that we're covering that day. And then A, asking that question. So having the question in mind before I get to that teaching moment, and then pairing them up so they have time to chew the information, to process the information. And once they have that, then they're able to regurgitate that information or to share that with the class. And so just picking that non-volunteer. Once they share, you know, I'm listening, I'm processing, I'm gathering the data, listening to the feedback, and then I can share some timely feedback so that the students walk away with something more than what I originally taught.
So we notice that the histogram bars are stuck together, okay? Why? Do you notice something about this bar right here? What numbers do you see on the bottom of that bar? What numbers? 135 to 140. Put a little hyphen there, okay? Because this is what we call a range. It's between 135 and 140, okay? Let's talk about the next bar. You see this bar right here? What's my range for that one? 140 to 145. Put a little hyphen there. Okay, we'll do one more just to make our point. Here's what I'm gonna have you do. You're gonna go to your whiteboards, the same ones you were at earlier. You're gonna answer those four questions. You need a whiteboard marker, and you can take an eraser if you'd like to erase your whiteboard. All right, go.
So one is six students because they, you know, 3 to 5 video games in play.
Number one is the
six. Then number two. How many people,
how many students? Five.
Five, so you're gonna count.
Six?
No, it's like 24, it's 24. Yeah, 24. I don't think you count these. It's 3 to 5 and you don't know how many students have three.
So how many video games?
What
is the median of the students who own video games?
Okay, so don't count this one, just count these.
Yeah, so we're talking about the median now.
Group 10, can you tell me how many students own more than 5 video games?
How many students own more than 5 video games is 24 because you don't count the 3 to 5 because you don't know how many students have 3 video games.
Okay. Athena, tell me then, what did you count to get 24?
We counted 6 to 8.
You can point, it's okay.
6 to 8 and 9, 11.
Ooh. What, 6 to 8? What are these things called, Athena? Athena, what are these things called?
Intervals.
Okay. Yeah, the intervals and ranges. So you counted which ones?
6 to 8 and 9, 11.
And?
9, 12 and 14.
Good. So what's 12 plus 8 plus 4, y'all? 24. You guys did amazing on that one. Thank you so much. Let's give them a clap. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
When I have failed to use explicit direct instruction, I don't have the feedback to help drive my lessons. That immediate feedback from the students is missing because I don't know what they're thinking. They don't know what I'm thinking, and that processing time gets lost in just doing math. And so the learning is lost, and it turns into just doing.
3, 2, 1, excellent. All right, you guys ready? Frequency, everybody say frequency. Because what number does this represent? 5. So a frequency is how often something happens, okay? What is frequency? Yeah, how often something happens. Everybody show me frequency.
It doesn't matter what type of teacher you are, what type of approach you take. Some people take more systematic approaches to things, and other people may be a little bit more creative, but TAPPLE works for everybody. It may be very clear to someone you're watching a lesson, there's a T, there's an A. Other times it may not be as clear, but it's not about how you deliver, it's about the planning before and making sure that you're hitting that T, that A, you know, all parts of TAPPLE. But it can absolutely be done by anybody, no matter what your teaching style is.